Please turn your mobile phones to silent mode as we begin the celebration of the Holy Mass. Please all stand and let us sing the entrance hymn.
My dear brothers and sisters.
Good evening, Father.
Today we celebrate the feast of St. John the Apostle Evangelist. As we celebrate this Holy Mass, let us pray for our own intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the blessed Apostle John have unlocked for us the secrets of your word, grant, we pray, that we may grasp with proper understanding what he has so marvelously brought to our ears, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the beginning of the first letter of St. John. Beloved, what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we looked upon and touched with our hands concerns the word of life. For the life was made visible. We have seen it and testified to it and proclaim to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was made visible to us. What we have seen and heard, we proclaim now to you, so that you too may have fellowship with us. For our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing this so that our joy may be complete. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just. The Lord is King, let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Clouds and darkness are around him. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all peoples see his glory.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Light dawns for the just, and gladness for the upright of heart. Be glad in the Lord, you just, and give thanks to his holy name.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just. Please all stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. We praise you, O God. We acclaim you as Lord. The glorious company of apostles with you. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him. So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran past than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there, and the clothes that had covered his head, not with the burial clothes, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who was arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. Today we celebrate the feast of St. John the Apostle and Evangelist. As we heard the Gospel for today, he is the beloved disciples. Sino ba si St. John the Evangelist? Siya ang naging saksi o witness kung ano ang nangyari sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo. No? Sa kanyang kamatayan ay naganap ang ito yung siya rin po yung sumulat ng tatlong letter ni St. John sa ating sa New Testament. And also he is the author of the fourth gospel, no, si St. John. At ang huling kanyang sinulat nung kanyang katandaan bago siya mamatay, ito yung pahayag o yung Apocalypse sa Ingles. Kung titingnan po natin, saan ba niya sinulat ito? Isinulat ni St. John the Evangelist ang kanyang huling sulat doon sa Greece, no, tinatawag na Patmon, na doon ipinapahayag niya na si Jesus ay totoong tao at totoong Diyos. At kung titingnan po natin, ano ba yung nilalaman ng kanyang sulat? No, alam po natin, halimbawa sa inyo po, sino ang mahilig magsulat ng kanyang diary? No, lahat po tayo, maaring pwede rin po tayong magsulat ng ating diary. At babalikan natin kung ano yung nangyari ng the past. Sa seminaryo po, ni-encourage kami o yung mga seminarista na magsulat ng kanilang diary. At para pag sila ay naging santo, bubuklatin nila iyon. No? Titingnan nila at magiging basihan po nila kung ano ang nangyayari sa kanilang journey bilang isang pari o isang seminarista. Sa ating buhay, mga kapatid, mas maaari o mas maganda na tayo ay magsusulat din. At para babalikan natin o babaliktanawin natin kung ano ba yung nangyari nung mga 1 week or 1 month or 1 year. Kaya mga kapatid, gaya ni San Juan Evangelista, na siya ay pinahayag niya yung witness niya, na witness niya kung anong nangyari sa ating Panginoon. No? Kaya kung titingnan po natin mga kapatid, ano ba yung nilalaman ng kanyang sulat, yung kanyang gospel? Sinasabi to dito na pinupokus niya ang kanyang sulat na ipinayag niya si Kristo ay totoong Diyos at totoong tao. At sinasabi niya rin dito po mga kapatid, dahil siya ang salita ng Diyos na nagkatawang tao. Yun po ang nilalaman ng kanyang sulat o ng kanyang ebanghelyo. Ang ebanghelyo din po ay nagpapayag kung paano niya nakita yung bato ng libingan na na-empty na, no? Na naka-roll up na yung cloth na ibinalot sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Nasaksihan niya iyon. Na ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo ay nabuhay na magmuli. Kung titingnan po natin, mga kapatid, you witness kung ano nangyari. Nabuhay muli ang ating Panginoon. Nangawa tayo rin, no? Ngayon ay season ng Christmas. No? Pangilang araw na po natin, no, na ipinagdiriwang ang Christmas na ito. Noong mga 24, 23, 22, nagigreet na tayo ng Christmas. Anong 25? Pagkatapos ng 25, nag-greet pa rin ba tayo ng Christmas? Marahil hindi na. Ngayon ay panahon ng Christmas. Kaya kung titingnan po natin, ang paanyaya po sa atin ng Pasko ayon sa ating ipinagdiriwa ngayon ay sumampalataya pa rin tayo sa salitang nagkatawang tao at tanggapin natin ito sa ating buhay. Kaya mga kapatid, ano ba yung kailangan natin tignan? Tignan natin ang ating buhay kung tayo ay sumasampalataya sa Diyos. No? Marahil karamihan po sa atin na nakakaranas sa mga problema, minsan ay nawawala yung pananampalataya natin. O minsan naman, humihina ang pananampalataya natin. Ang nakakalungkot mga kapatid, minsan, kapag nakaranas tayo ng mga mabibigat na problema, lumilipat tayo. No? O kaya naman, nasisisi natin ng Diyos, bakit ako pa? Marami naman makasalanan diyan. Marami naman ang bakit hindi sila makaranas ng mga problemang ito? Mga kapatid, yan ay biyaya ng Diyos na ipinapaalala po sa atin na tayo ay mahal ng Diyos. Na kailangan lamang po natin pagtibayin ang ating pananampalataya. Every day, kung titingnan po natin, lahat naman tayo ay nakakaranas ng mga pagsubok. Sa pagsubok na yan, magiging matatag po tayo. No? At kailangan lamang po nating harapin ang mga pagsubok na ito. Kaya sa pagdiriwang natin ng kapistahan ni San Juan, Apostle and Evangelist, inaanyayahan po tayo na maging matatag ang ating pananampalataya. Kapag naging matatag ang ating pananampalataya, tayo ang magbibigay ng pag-asa sa bawat isa. Nanawa tayong lahat ay maging bridge o tulay para lumago ang pananampalataya ng iba. Ngunit ano po ang hamon po para sa ating pinagdiriwang ngayon? Ang hamon po sa atin ni San Juan Bautista, nanawa ay maging witness tayo, totoong witness na magpapatotoo tayo sa mga nagugulimihanan sa kanilang buhay. Kaya mga kapatid, sa tagpo ng Ebanghelyong ito, nanawa makita po natin ang totoong salitang Emmanuel sa ating buhay. Sa ngalan ng Ama at ng Anak at ng Espiritu Santo.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Ako ay isang batang pasto na patungo sa sabsaban. Tayo na, nasa Belen, tayo nasa Belen. At to'y kay sarap magawitan sa tabi ng sabsaban. Tayo na, nasa Belen, tayo nasa Belen. At do'y kay sarap magawitan sa tabi ng sabsaban.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Sanctify the offerings we have made, O Lord, we pray, And grant that from the banquet of this supper, we may draw the hidden wisdom of the eternal word, just as from this same source, you revealed it to your Apostle John, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the mystery of the world made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of all things invisible. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, the Son of Elias. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna.
Unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, upon of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dupo, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gilbert our Archbishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints you have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honors is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Please all stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you were the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Lord, the kingdom, the power, and the
Lord Jesus Christ, said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us of each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. On us, Lord.
Able to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Angels, we have heard the night sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply echoing their joyous strains. Is Deo Gloria, in excelsis is Deo. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? Say, what may the tidings be which inspire your heavenly song? Gloria in excelsis Deo. Come, adore on bended knee, Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
The second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of Saint Father Pio. Thank you for your offering.
Of the skies, great angelic heaven and nature sings. In heaven and heaven and nature sings.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the world made flesh, proclaimed by the blessed Apostle John, may through this mystery which we have celebrated, ever dwell among us through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Santo Padre Pio. All together, Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that you concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit, and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa Pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakiingatan ang inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, mga kapiyo, kami po ay humihingi na inyong kaunting oras at pakikiisa para sa pagsusulat ng inyong mga pangalan at ilang detalye sa ating Pilgrims Information Record Books na makikita sa paligid nating mga simbahan. Ito po ay bahagi ng documentation program para sa pagpapalawig ng mga datos at turismong pangsimbahan at bilang alaala din ng inyong pagbisita sa Pambansang Dambana. Para sa ating mga balikbayan, OFW at makakasama ninyong foreigners, doon po kayo magsusulat sa International Pilgrims Record Book. Gagabayan po kayo ng ating mga tagapaglingkod. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas ng religious articles.
Mga kapatid, manalangin tayo sa Diyos, amang makapangyarihan, upang tayo maging kawangis ni Kristo sa taimtim na pagdalangin sa tulong mga larawan at mga dasalan. O Panginoong Diyos, Ikaw ang bukal ng lahat ng pagpapala at biyaya, ibuhos mo ang iyong bendisyon sa mga gamit na ito sa panalalangin, mga rosaryo, imahen, dasalan na nagpapaalala ang iyong kabutihan, kabanalan at pagmamahal sa amin, upang ang lahat na dumudulog ay magdasal, gamit ang mga ito ay magtamo ng iyong awa at biyaya. Loobin mong tularan nila ang kabanalan at aral ng Panginoon at ng mga santo magpas sa walang hanggan.
Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be, forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be, forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be, forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be, forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Hosanna, Pasko na, Pasko na, tayo'y magkaisa. Magsama sa saya ng sanggol at inang.